Christopher, and he is calling from Arcata, I think, California, listening on Immaculate Heart Radio. Hello, Christopher.
Hello, Tim. Thank you for taking my call, and thank you for... I've got a lot of inspiration from watching your videos on YouTube, the debates, your conversion story. There's lots of good stuff out there.
Fantastic. All right.
My question is, I have all of these debates with my Protestant coworker, always, you know, why are you Catholic? Why are you Protestant? And we go back and forth. And for him, it always goes down to John 3:16. Everything that I answer, he goes, you don't need all of that extra stuff. John 3:16, all you have to do is believe and be saved.
Yes.
And for evidence of it, he points to the thief on the cross. He says, look, he didn't follow Jesus' teachings and he got saved,
mm-hmm.
all because he believed.
Right.
So how do I say that you need to do more than just believe? How do you, I don't know, sort of answer,
yes.
well, you don't have to do anything besides John 3:16.
Sure. Well, Christopher, there's a very important principle Jesus gave us in Luke chapter 12, verse 48. He says, to whom much is given, much shall be required. Notice, he didn't say to whom much is given, much will be, well, it'd be kind of nice if you do it. No, he says, to whom much is given, much shall be required. Jesus teaches that you're only responsible for what you know or what you ought to have known or what you have available to you. In the case of the thief on the cross, of course, he couldn't hardly rip himself down off of the cross and be baptized and, you know, enter into the church and so forth. He could not do that. He did everything God asked of him, everything that he could do, and that is he called out to Jesus for salvation, and that suffices. But you know what, Christopher, you might point this out to him. If he would have miraculously been, you know, pulled down off the cross, right, and survived, then he would have been responsible to do everything that Jesus commands. You know, I'll toss out another very important text. That's Matthew 28:18. Jesus said, all authority in heaven and earth is given me. Go, therefore, teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe and do all according to that which I've taught you. And lo, I'll be with you all days, even to the end of the age. I quoted 18 through 20 there. So notice, Christopher, Jesus says you have to do everything. Now, go to Mark 16:16. The same Jesus who said that if you believe in him, you'll be saved, inspired author here, St. Mark, to write in Mark 16:16, he that believes and is baptized shall be saved. See, Christopher, according to Jesus, according to the New Testament, you also have to be baptized. Again, only if you have the possibility of being baptized, as I mentioned, thief on the cross, no. I mean, some argue, well, he was presumably baptized. I think that's completely unnecessary. It's not in sacred scripture, and it's not necessary. We have a teaching in the Catholic Church. We refer to this as the baptism of desire. If someone desires Christ and intends to do what Christ wills for him to do, we refer that as a baptism of desire. Also, you'll want to point out Matthew chapter 10, verse 22 to your coworker, because there Jesus says, you shall be hated of all men for my name's sake, but he that endures till the end shall be saved. So we have to continue to what? Endure till the end in order to finally be saved. Revelation 2:10, Jesus says, be thou faithful unto death, and I will give you the crown of life. Christopher, what we have here is a classic example. We mentioned this in the last hour, of someone taking a verse of scripture out of context, absolutizing it, and saying this is all we need. That is not what sacred scripture teaches. Look, you can't teach everything in every verse of scripture. Does that make sense, Christopher?
Yeah, it does, and thank you for those passages, Matthew 28:18, Mark 16:16, and Matthew 10:22. I'll have to show those to him next time.
You got it. And throw in Revelation 2:10 as well, brother, okay?
Copy that. Thank you, Tim.
All right. God love you.